Adobe's added some amazing AI tools into Photoshop and Lightroom. Today, we're going to be looking at the AI selection tools on the face, where literally it can select different parts of the face. But more than that, there's one-click presets that you may not be aware of. We're going to be using these inside of Camera Raw today, but the same ones are available inside of Lightroom.
So let's choose a filter, Camera Raw filter. All right, before I go through and I show you all the settings, I've got some really cool tricks, but the first one I want to show you is how to use the built-in presets. So if we go down to the preset here, and you'll also find that in the develop module on the left-hand side in Lightroom, see where it says adaptive portrait? If I roll over, you can see what it's going to do is it's literally going to detect the different parts of the photo and retouch it. Now the gritty portrait is not going to look good. Enhance eyes, look at that, see that? Enhance teeth, darken eyebrows, add texture to hair, or smoothen the hair. All right, so you can click any of those if you're in a hurry, or you can do these manually. Now, to manually do these, what we're going to do is choose the masking tool. Now, when we click on mask, you'll notice the generate new masks, but we're going to go down to the people. Now, if there's more than one person in the image, you'll see a list of all the different people, and you can actually automatically select different parts of all those people. I covered that in my Lightroom tutorial. Check that out because it applies to Camera Raw. It's the same. Now what we're going to do is we're going to click on the person. Now this is going to open it up. By default, entire person is going to be selected. So you can see the mask has got that whole person. Any adjustments we make are just going to be to the person. So this is nice. We want to lighten or darken it. But if we want to hone in and we want to actually retouch different parts of the face, look at this. It's really quite amazing. So we can click on the face skin. So, you know, if we want to make adjustments just to that, look at that. It can do the body skin independently, which is really nice. We can do the eye sclera, which is the whites of the eyes. We can do the iris and the pupil. We definitely want to include those. And we can do the teeth and the hair. Now, if I click create, what's going to happen is all of these are going to be put into one selection. So that means when I adjust it, I'm not going to be able to adjust any of these individually. All of them are going to adjust together. If I choose create five separate masks, and now I create, when we look up here, we can see those different parts now have been put into individual masks. And this is a great way to go in and do the adjustment. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to reset this because I've got a great trick for you to kind of speed things up. So we're just going to reset all the way. Okay, before we jump in and do that, why don't we do some quick retouching here? We want to zoom in on our model, which is Megan. Let's grab, say, 50%. And I'm going to hit the space bar, and this enables me to move around. So why don't we fix some of these larger areas? And these are done quite quickly with another new feature, and that's under the healing brush. So if we go to the healing brush, you'll notice that there's now three options. We're going to choose the middle option, which is healing. And then I'm going to use the right bracket key to make these larger, left bracket key to make it smaller. So make it just a little larger than the spots. And then we just simply click to remove any of these spots. Now, before I go through and I adjust all of these, watch this. If I select, say, this spot here, and I don't like the way that adjustment looks, just watch it under the cursor. If I use the forward slash key, it will select from a different area. Look at that. Each time I hit the forward slash key, it's going to use a different area. So now I'm just going to go through and I'm going to speed these up. I just wanted to give you that little tip because I love giving you guys tips. All right, I'm not really worried about the small ones. I just want to get the large ones. We hit the backslash key. We can see there's before and after. Now, by the way, if we have other photos in exactly the same position, you know, as far as the pose, maybe of different facial expressions, we could sync those spots so we don't have to redo them in each photo. All right. Let's speed things up now. What we're going to do is we're going to go back to this preset. Now, I'm not necessarily going to want to use the settings in the preset, but this is a quick way to create all the masks. So we're going to grab Glamour Portrait. And right now, notice it does the adjustment. Now, these are not necessarily the adjustments I want, but this, we go into the mask here. Notice what it does is it creates all these different parts for us. So this saves us time when we're going through and making our own adjustments. All right, so let's have a look and see what we've got. Let's start with the iris and the pupil. I want to make these eyes look better. Now, look at that. It's increased the exposure. That's not necessarily how I would want to do it. I'm going to take the exposure back, and I'm going to open up the shadows. Notice how that just adds a nice little bit of pop to the eyes, just kind of shows the color. So let's continue here. What we want to do is do the hair. So let's just scroll down And if you look under the hair, you'll notice that we've got texture and clarity. I personally don't like negative clarity, so I'm just going to set that to zero. And we can do the hair. Now, if you increase it, it shows more definition. But if you take it to the left, look how silky it makes. You don't want to go to the right. Look at that. It just makes it look dried out. You want to avoid that. So let's go to the left, make it look smoother, more silky. Great. Why don't we have a look at the sclerera and the see what they've done here. Oh no, they've increased the exposure. I don't like that. I don't know who did these presets, but I mean, I'm sure they're great, but I have my own kind of taste in the way I like to do things. I don't like to ever brighten the whites in the eyes because it makes it look ghoulish, in my opinion. What I like to do is just take the saturation down. And if we look here, I notice in the preset they did that, reduced the saturation. Because see how it just takes the red? If you look in here, some of these areas, you see the red in the eyes. Take that saturation down. Gets rid of the red in the eyes, looking nice. And I would say same thing for the teeth. Let's have a look. Did they increase the exposure? They did a little bit. I'm just going to put that back. And just once again, I just want to go with that saturation. See that? As we reduce the saturation, it whitens the teeth. Without making them look glaringly white, you know, I don't like to brighten these things because I don't like the results you get from that. All right, so we can see that. Let's look at something else. Let's look at the hair. The face. So here we grab the face and look what's happened here. Looks like that opened up the shadows a little bit. I'm just going to put those back just a touch. And my guess is they probably also gone and done negative clarity. Let's have a look. Did they? Yeah, there's that negative clarity again. Let's get rid of that. Go back to zero. And we're going to use the texture. So the texture here, if you look, there's the regular skin. As we push it to the left, notice that's way too much. You don't want that. So you want to just kind of dial it in where you've got a nice kind of a soft skin. It's just kind of softening the texture without going too far. Now, one of the things I've noticed too is this face is looking just a little bit too bright and looks like, what have we got here going on at the color temperature? Yeah, we've got a -5 going there. So we just want to warm that back up a little bit. I like to warm the face up a little. All right. And if we look at that, let's go to the fit and view. There we go. Now it looks like we got a little bit of goosebumps here going in some of the areas here on her skin and her body. So we can add that to the mask. All right. So let's just create a new mask. We're going to choose select people. That's going to find her again. And what we're looking for here is just the body skin. So great. We've got that. We create. There's our body skin. And let's just take down the texture a little bit on this. There we go. And see what that does is just kind of reduces those goosebumps a little bit. Before, goosebumps. After, gone. Nice. And when we're done, we just click OK. And here we are before, after.
So I don't know about you, but I think these new AI tools are pretty amazing. Let me know in the comments underneath if you learned anything new. And by the way, if you're here on Photoshop Cafe, check that you have subscribed. I know some of you guys have been watching for a while and you haven't yet clicked the subscribe button. And also if you're new, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and then you won't miss any of my tutorials. So anyway, guys, hit that like button, helps with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.